Hello, fellow musicians. Well, the answer to the question, can you save hundreds of dollars by doing a single U.S. copyright album instead of multiple U.S. copyrights of individual songs is... Depends. Okay, so sorry, it is a bit of a trick question, but please let me explain. Please remember, I am not a copyright attorney. Any advice you use based on this video is at your own risk. Beware. I gathered all the information for this video June 2019, so these calculations could change without notice. First of all, if you choose to copyright your songs using the U.S. copyright website, the amount of savings would depend on how many songs would be on the album. Since an unpublished album of 10 songs with all lyrics and music written by the same author would be $55, according to my unconfirmed calculations, and the cost of doing 10 individual songs computes to $350, 10 times $35, according to my unconfirmed calculations. So, if my calculations are correct, you could save $295, which would be hundreds of dollars. Second of all, it is my understanding, based on my limited research, that many people believe a song can be and should be copywritten without ever using the U.S. copyright website. So if you copyright using another method besides the U.S. copyright website, you may be able to do it for free for an album or for individual songs. However, there's also a big issue regarding your ability to bring a lawsuit that I will touch upon at the end of this video that supports why I believe it is very important to register with the U.S. copyright website. You will need to do your own research on this topic and decide for yourself how and if you want to do a copyright. I am just giving you a sample of a copyright I recently did myself to the best of my limited knowledge. Okay, so here's the game plan, fellow musicians. First, a brief disclaimer. Pause on any screens if you need more time to read them. I will start by showing you about 24 print screens from the U.S. copyright website, taken as I was processing my new album named BPM. To give you an overview of the process, at the end of the video I will talk about FAQ, that is, frequently asked questions, and where you can get the answers to them. I included a couple of FAQ print screens that you should read. They include the lawsuit issue I spoke of earlier. And please don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe button at the end of the video. I also added portions of my new songs 60 and 68 for your listening pleasure. So now I'm about to show you about 24 print screens from the copyright website. There will be no audio, so pause if you need to read them. Please enjoy. Just a quick side note, you will be adding your personal information, name, etc. to the screens instead of mine. Also, I added some red arrows and some step one, step two notations to help you with this overview. to get to this FAQ webpage, you would link from the original homepage. So I hope you enjoyed the video. Again, please subscribe and hit the like button if you liked it.